Hey students, we are beginning the last day topic digestion and absorption. Here the topic is teeth. Yesterday I already discussing. The bulk part of the teeth is composed of the dentine. The teeth it will be categorized into three parts. They called as the crown and neck, and your basal part is called as the root. So here we have to discussing about of the dentition, human dentition. Here the arrangement of the teeth on jawbones is called as the dentition. The human dentition it will be categorized into three types. They called as the thecodont type, thecodont, and here diphyodont and etiodont type. So first of all, we discussing about the thecodont. Means of here, the teeth which is fixed at the socket of the jawbone, it will be called as the thecodont type. Human teeth is fixed at the socket of the jawbone. The diphyodont means here two sets of the teeth which is appeared in their lifetime, it will be called as the diphyodont type. Two sets of the teeth appeared in their lifetime. The first set of teeth is called as milk teeth. Milk teeth, they are in number 20. Here, the milk teeth is replaced by your permanent teeth. Permanent teeth. Those are 32 in adult humans. The next one, heterodont type. Here four types of teeth is located at the jawbones. The four types is called as here incisors, canine, premolar, and molars. Premolar and molars. Here commonly four types of teeth which is variable in shape and variable in function, hence it will be called as the heterodont type. Incisors, which is sharpened, which has a sharpened margins, which is called as the incisor teeth. They cutting the food particles. They are very well developed in the herbivores. Canines, they called as the here dagger-like teeth. So which is helped in the tearing of the food particles. They are mostly developed in the carnivores. Premolars, molars, they called as the cheek teeth. Cheek teeth. They are helped in grinding or the masticate of the food particles. Here four types of the teeth is located at the jawbones. Hence they will be called as the heterodont type. The next one here, dental formula. Dental formula. Here dental formula represents here dental formula. Here it is represents the arrangement of the teeth on off of the each jaw. Arrangement of the teeth in each off of the both jaws, in upper and lower jaws, they represented as ICP. But ICP. Incisors, canines, premolars, molars. The adult dental formula is dental formula of adult human beings. Adult human beings 2123 by 2123. Here the first one upward it will be represented as incisors is 2, canines is 1, premolars is 2, and molars is 3. Here 2 plus 1 3, 3 plus 2 5, 5 plus 3 8. Here upper jaw, the half of the upper jaw has 8 teeth. And half of the lower jaw has about of 8 teeth. It means that the half of the jaw contains 16 teeth. 16 teeth. Another half of the also has a vert of 16 feet. It will be 16 to the 32. So adult human beings contain 32 teeth in member. Here the dental form of milk teeth, dental formula in a baby. Here 2102/2102. Here it is. The loss of the premolars will be here observed in a baby, and last molar teeth also absent in a baby. It means of the milk teeth dentition is 2102/2102. Here about of 2+1 3, 3+2 here 5. Half of the upper jaw has 5 teeth. Half of the lower jaw has 5 teeth. Here it is about of 5 10. Half of the another jaw also has about of same 10 teeth. Completely 20 in number. Milk teeth dentition is 20 in number. Here absence of the teeth in your baby they called as the premolars and the last molar teeth. These last molar teeth is appeared at the age of the 17 to 21st age. The teeth it will be called as the wisdom teeth. So they are commonly vestigial part of the body. They called as the vestigial teeth also. Okay. So they are located in the gum region. So actually there is no sufficient oral cavity. There is no sufficient space is present in the jawbone. Hence it will be only appears at the age of the 17 to 21st age. This is about of the complete information about of teeth. Then next we have to discussing about of the tongue. The point is the oral cavity has about of two parts or contains two parts. They called as the teeth and the tongue. Then we have to discussing about of the tongue. So tongue it is commonly a muscular sense organ. So tongue is a muscular sense organ located at the oral cavity, which is attached at the floor of the buccal cavity, the floor of the oral cavity, with a folded tissue. The folded tissue is called as the frenulum. Tongue it is attached to the base of the oral cavity by a fold of tissue will be called as the frenulum. The tongue, here the surface of the tongue, it will be exposed with a papillae. The papillae will be here classified into three types. Papillae will be classified into three types. They called as here fungiform, filiform, and circumvallate, and foliate type. Foliate it will be rudimentary in adults. Here we have to discussing about of the main three types of the here papillae. The location it is commonly the fungiform papillae, which is located anterior tip of the tongue. Fungiform. Here about a filiform, which is present at the surface of the tongue. Filiform located at the here about of surface of the tongue. The basal, here posterior basal part of the tongue and the sides of the tongue, which is called as the circumvallate type. At the tip of the tongue, fungi form, surface of the tongue is called as the filiform, and basal part of the tongue is called as the circumbone. Foliate is located at the 1/3 of the basal part of the tongue. 1/3 of the basal part of the tongue means of sides of the tongue, the location of the foliate papillae. Okay, here it is tongue, it will be act as a universal toothbrush which cleans the teeth first of all, and also which act as a taste detection and helps in the mixing of the saliva with the food particles, and also helps in a swallowing. It is called as the universal toothbrush, and also here taste detection helps in here about the mixing of the saliva and also swallowing purposes. So here the tongue also has a lot of taste detecting, okay, now locations. Here the anterior tip of the tongue will be detect the taste of the sweetness, and here basal part of the tongue it will be detect the taste of bitter. Here anterior margins it will be detect the here about of saltiness character, and here commonly the sides of the tongue and posterior sides of it will be detect the sour purpose. Okay, here anterior it will be sweet and posterior basal part it is bitter, and anterior laterals or sides it will be detect saltiness, and about of basal part of the posterior basal part of it means lateral side it detect the sour nerve. This is about of the tongue. The next we have to discussing about of the oral cavity. It will be leads into a short passage. It will be called as pharynx pod. Pharynx pod. Pharynx. Here it is. Buccal cavity leads into a short passage is called as the pharynx. Here pharynx, it will be a common passage for air and food, because of here trachea and esophagus opens into the region of pharynx region, hence it will be called as common passage for air and food. Air and food. Here pharynx, it will be divided into three parts by the presenting of the uvula. That is what the first part it is called as the nasopharynx and oropharynx and laryngopharynx. Laryngopharynx. So here nasopharynx, which is located above the soft palate, and middle is called as the oropharynx, and below the soft palate has laryngopharynx. The nasopharynx, which is communicated with the middle ear through the Eustachian tubes. Eustachian tubes. Middle ear communicates with the nasopharynx through the Eustachian tubes. Here laryngopharynx, here the particular trachea it will be opens into the laryngopharynx region through the glottis. The glottis is covered with a flap-like structure. The flap-like structure is called as the epiglottis. Epiglottis. It is a soft lid or the ear. A flap-like structure which covers the glottis. The epiglottis prevents the entry of the food while in the swallowing of the food. During the swallowing of the food, the epiglottis prevents the entry of the food into the trachea regions. Then here we have to discussing about of the muscles of pharynx. The muscles here commonly voluntary muscles are present in a pharynx region, those are helped in a sovereign purposes.